In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Good morning.
Morning.
Good morning.
On this, what's turned out to be a beautiful morning, I'd like to talk to you all about trust. Trust in God. Let me ask you a question. Do you trust God? Do you trust that He loves you, that He has a plan for you, that whatever it is that you are going through in life or have gone through has been seen by Him and will somehow help toward your salvation? Do you trust that He is willing to forgive you completely if you repent, if you ask it? Do you trust that He is more powerful than anything you might be afraid of? That last one's a toughie. There's a lot of things this day and age to be afraid of. I would dare say that fear is a strong undercurrent in our world today, that it's responsible for quite a lot that people do and say these days. In the gospel story today of the gathering of demoniacs, it's easy to get distracted by the elements that are so fantastic and unlike our normal everyday lives. You know, here we see these wild, violent, frightening examples of the kind of demonic possession that Hollywood loves. You know, we have these naked guys, these demoniacs living in a graveyard, scaring the heck out of the townspeople, so powerful that chains cannot hold them. And then the hero comes, sets them free, and sends the demons into a herd of swine that then run screaming over a cliff into the sea to drown. I mean, wow. A movie producer didn't ask for a better story than that. But today I want us to look at a detail of a story that's very near to all of us. Detail that I want us to look at is fear. Fear. Everyone in this story, except for Jesus, is afraid. The demoniacs and the demons in them were afraid. The townspeople were afraid of the demoniacs. They were still afraid, even after they were healed, because they were afraid that Jesus might change their lives too much. So they asked Him to leave. In any case, it was fear that drove these poor souls to isolate themselves in a graveyard, a place that always evokes fear, from which they not only lived in fear, but made their business to frighten everybody else who had to die. And evidently, this atmosphere of fear was a big part of the life of the gatherings, much like in our own times. I'm sure everyone in town knew the story of the scary demoniacs who lived in the tombs. Kind of like the way that people used to live in fear of the mysterious gravity to kill a mockingbird. Fear is something with which we're all familiar. Think how the tenor of life has changed in this country after 9/11. Our national discourse seems to be revolving almost entirely around fear as of late. Even in the church, you know, what's happened at the Supreme Court judgment? What's going to happen to churches? What's going to happen to our taxes and status? What's going to happen when people live in our homes? And so on and so on. We fear, and it's a terrible way to live. I mean, we fear employment, poverty, starvation, cancer, crime. We even fear truth and honesty. Bearing witness to the truth can land someone into a lot of trouble these days. So what do we do? Our mouths shut, and we run from the things that frighten us. We live in gated communities. We take lots of various medications and drink lots of alcohol. We eat lots of food. We watch lots of television to numb our minds, anything to take away our fear. And all these little fears that we're afraid of come from the one big fear, and that's the fear of death. And it's interesting, in today's gospel reading, Jesus calls us to do something quite different And when we're used to doing it with fear, he invites us not to run away from it. Jesus didn't run away from the demoniacs. He met them face to face. He didn't run away from both of them. He met death face to face. It doesn't mean he wasn't afraid. Of course he was afraid. Read the account of his agonizing prayers in Gethsemane, where he sweated blood as he prayed. But courageous people are not those who never experience fear, but rather those who know it intimately, but don't let it rule over them. So we're invited to meet our fears head on, with faith, and most importantly, to trust God, who will never, ever forsake us, who is more powerful than anything that we're afraid of. That's why we put that icon at the top of the church.
Amen.
Christ, the Bambuquerato, the all-powerful. He is above and over everything. If we're willing and able to trust God, we will discover that the monster we so feared may not be so fearful after all. Take, for instance, the life of our uncle St. Anthony. There's St. Anthony there, who looks like a monk, and there's St. Anthony over there. We must have had a lot of Anthony's when we built the church, because that's why we have all these St. Anthony windows. But he's the father of the monasticism. And, like the Gathering demoniacs, he went to the tombs, but for a different reason. He didn't go there because he was driven by fear. He went there in order to meet his fears and overcome them. There's lots of stories about St. Anthony encountering and battling all kinds of demons. And some of those demons were in the guise of ferocious animals. And some of them were just scary-looking supernatural creatures. But whatever they looked like, Anthony didn't win his struggles by running away from the tombs. He won them by prayer, meditation, and fasting. In other words, by facing all that he had to face with courage and with trust in God, who was always near. In fact, in one story, by the way, this biography was written by a very Saint Athanasius. But in one story, after a particularly harrowing battle with demons all night long, Anthony asked God, "Where were you?" And a light came into the tomb, and a voice said, "I was here all along." And Anthony realized that it was indeed through God's help that he survived the ordeal. That the struggle was being witnessed and blessed by God, and that God was purifying St. Anthony's heart by allowing him to suffer the way that he did. So we need to take heart when we're faced with those things that fear us. Frighten us. We all have problems we need to face, fears that need to be admitted, sins that need reconciling, and this can't be done by hiding from them or pretending that they don't exist. Instead of running away, we need to stop and look deeply at what it is that frightens us. We need to be honest with ourselves, and we need to let go. Let go of trying to control it. Let go of trying to deny it. Let go of trying to hide it. We need to be still and know that our Lord is God, almighty, all-powerful, and to welcome the opportunity to face these things when they arise, so that our sovereign Lord, Jesus Christ, can manifest his power and glory in our lives. I was just at joint camp for the past 2 Wednesdays, helping out with confessions for the kids. And many times, they would come to confession for the first time, you know, and they're a little scared and nervous. They don't know what they're supposed to do or say, so you have to kind of guide them through it. And for some of them, one of the things I would say is that all God asks of us in confession is just to be as honest as we can about who we truly are. Be honest about what it is that angers us, or frightens us, or tempts us, or makes us jealous, or makes us fight with our brother and sister and talk back to our parents. You know, what is it that makes us do these things? Let's be honest with ourselves. Because the Lord invites us to leave our masks behind and to come to him as we are. Christ fills in the strength behind our weakness. He fills in the courage behind our fear. He is the backbone that we need to face our fears. And so in the times that we're afraid, we should trust in God, call upon His holy name, and tell the demons in our life, no matter how scary they might be, to go jump off a cliff. Because the Lord, all powerful, is our courage and our strength.